In the United States Army, the MOS of a 92 Yankee is a unit supply specialist. Before we dive into the basic summary of this MOS, make sure you hit that subscribe button and maybe even think about enabling notifications so you can get alerts as soon as I do live streams, new MOS Mondays drop, all that fun stuff. So let's talk about some of the duties of a 92 Yankee. The job duties of the unit supply specialist is going to include things like receiving, inventory, unit issue, as well as some 92 Yankees will also work in an arms room. Now, from my experience, sometimes that might vary because I've had situations where it's somebody else, not a 92 Yankee, working in the arms room, but most often I've usually had 92 Yankees that are working in the arms room. Those people are gonna be doing things like maintenance on weapons, issuing weapons, things like that. But that one can vary, but most likely you'll be doing, you know, the basic stuff of issuing supplies, receiving supplies, keeping inventory of that, and then maybe some 92 Yankees will additionally also work in an arms room. This MOS is available to active duty, National Guard, and Reserves. Now, to get into this line of work in the United States Army, it is going to require you to either have a high school diploma or a GED. You're also going to have to take the ASVAB and get a qualifying AFQT score for the Army. But specifically for this MOS, you will need to get at least a 90 in the clerical section of the ASVAB. Now, the score from the clerical section of the ASVAB contains four different subjects. Those subjects are going to be word knowledge, paragraph comprehension, arithmetic reasoning, and mathematics knowledge. The training to become a 92 Yankee is going to include the normal 10 weeks of basic training, and then from there, you're gonna go off to 8 weeks of AIT at Fort Lee, Virginia. Now, in my experience of working with individuals that were 92 Yankees, they're usually at the unit level, at the company level, there's some kind of room, that's supply room, and that's the primary location of where they'd be working at, is inside a supply room, maintaining inventory, issuing things out. These are also individuals that'll probably be responsible for like what's called the BII, the basic inventory of, you know, your vehicle. So if you have like tools that are assigned to your vehicle, those, you know, pieces of equipment are kind of on that person's hand receipt or that inventory for that individual that is the main unit supply specialist. There's going to be other individuals that work in that supply room, but there's always one NCO that's kind of like the main unit supply specialist that's really the one handling everything. And then all the people that are under that individual is kind of just helping with the inventory, maintaining, and issuing of those supplies. Some of them, like I said, might be working in an arms room. If you are not actually the 92 Yankee yourself, then this is probably a good person to make friends with. Sometimes they have really good stuff. They got, you know, knives or Gerbers or iPro or gloves. Sometimes you can get some pretty cool hookups if you know the supply person and get this equipment maybe before everybody else, or maybe there's not enough for everybody to go around, but because you know that supply person, you get the hookups sometimes. But they're gonna maintain things like that. Sometimes you'll have Gerbers they're issuing out. Sometimes they'll have iPro that they have to issue out to everybody. But additionally to that, like the tools and the basic stuff, sometimes they have uniforms, sometimes boots, the basic things, like if you need like a box of pens or a notepad, this is the place you have to go, and they maintain that stuff. Sometimes the plates that go inside of the armor vest that the soldiers wear, usually get that sometimes from supply. So they just maintain inventory of a lot of equipment, a lot of those little, you know, office supply stuff, but also other bigger pieces of equipment as well, like the tools and a lot of other things that the unit supply specialists have to maintain inventory of. And then, like I said, some of those individuals will be working in the arms room, so when you go to do training and you need your weapon for that, maybe it's to go qualify or go to the field, you go to an arms room, it's kind of like a vault, it's got a security system, sometimes like a jail door almost on the front of it, and you'll go see that unit armorer, and you know, they'll issue out your weapon, they maintain the inventory of where the weapons are at, who they're signed out to, how many they have inside their arms room, how many they're supposed to have in their arms room, how many are out for maintenance to get repairs done, all that kind of stuff, and schedule those repairs as well. So some of the individuals will be working inside of like a warehouse type of environment, and some will be working inside of maybe like a small arms room for that company. Now, as far as jobs outside of the military, then this can easily apply to maybe, you know, someone who wants to work in a warehouse to maintain inventory. You can even really probably boost your resume and say that in the Army, I was responsible for millions and millions of dollars of equipment, because you were, so it sounds really fancy on a resume. Maybe if you were one of those unit armorers, maybe you have a little bit of experience with, you know, some basic weapon repair, so maybe you get a job in that line of work, or you could just simply switch careers altogether. Of the individuals that I knew that were 92 Yankees, I don't think any of them do anything related to what they did in the Army. There's one that I can think of that's a nurse now, so, you know, it's easy to probably just switch to a completely different career if that's what you wanted to do. So if any of you out there are currently 92 Yankees or previously were in the Army as a 92 Yankee, leave some comments down below. Tell me what you liked about the MOS and what you didn't like about the MOS to help out some people who are potentially interested in joining the Army to become a unit supply specialist. If you have any questions about maybe becoming a unit supply specialist, then make sure to leave some comments down below as well. I'll try to answer what I can. If I can't answer, then hopefully some of my veteran viewers and active duty viewers will be able to help me out down there in the comment section. If you have an MOS that you're interested in, make sure to leave it down in the comments section, as I do tend to look to that for motivation for the next episode of MOS Monday to see what MOS to cover. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you hit that thumbs up button. Check out some of the links down in the description to my social media and much more. I'm Christopher Chaos. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time. See ya.